Excel tricks that I learned at Trainertage. This is episode 1640, Formula Indenting. Alright, here's a cool trick. So I was sitting in the back of Dietmar Gieringer's class and I was watching him work. He's speaking in German. And the first thing I noticed, you know, we separate the arguments in our functions with commas. But in the German version of Excel, they can use semicolons. And so that's the first thing that caught my eye, but that doesn't work in the US version. But, you know, you are allowed to separate by comma and space. So you can add a little bit of space to help make the formula more readable, which in this case, you know, might or might not help. I'm going to go into the next worksheet where we have a much bigger formula. Okay, so you know, here's a really complicated formula. I realize you can't see the whole thing, that is doing a VLOOKUP with an offset, with a match, with a COUNTIF, a lot of different arguments going on inside of here. And of course, you can make the formula bar bigger using the V at the end of the formula bar. But here was the thing that was really interesting to me. In addition to being able to separate with a space after the comma, you're allowed to use Alt Enter. And you can actually have as many spaces as you want. All right, so Dietmar showed an example where he was talking about a formula. I think it was maybe index and match or some complicated formula. And he actually went through and used Alt-Enter and space to line up the formula, kind of indenting it like we would do in VBA. If you're a VBA programmer, you know, we indent the loops, we indent the if statements. And it allowed all of the arguments that were basically at the same level, the arguments for the offset function, to get lined up. All right, now rather than make you sit here and watch the whole thing, let me go to the next worksheet where I'll show you what it looks like. All right, so you know, here's a VLOOKUP. The VLOOKUP has arguments that are at this level. There's four arguments, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's an offset. There should be five arguments for offsets, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's a match with 1, 2, 3 arguments. I didn't bother to indent that one there. And so, you know, to a certain extent, this formula becomes much more readable. We're doing a VLOOKUP. As the second argument of the VLOOKUP, we're doing an offset. So in other words, the lookup table is being defined on the fly. Right? And so I think this is a little bit easier. The problem with this is that when the formula bar is collapsed, you don't get to see the whole formula. You're seeing just part of the formula. And so if I do Control Enter here, you see, you just see the first part of the formula, which might lead you to believe that it's just, you know, some weird VLOOKUP and you don't see the rest of it. So one of the people in the class, it was Dominic Petri, said, well, hey, wait, there's a solution to this, and it's my good old friend, the N function. And now N of a number is the number, but N of any text is zero. So we're going to add the N function. And in quotes here, just say, caution, long formula, expand the formula bar, close quotes. And now, when we see this formula, it'll say, hey, caution, long formula, you have to expand the formula bar to see the whole formula bar, and there you have it. All right, so I thought that was clever. I've never thought of actually using Alt-Enter to line up the formulas. I do this all the time with code. But I've never tried it with formulas. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank Dietmar for that cool trick. Of course, Dietmar has the Excel 2010 Idea book in German about dashboards. And also, a shout out to Dominic for throwing in the N function. Next year, Trainer Days, January 17th through the 21st, 2014, in Lucerne, Switzerland. Now, most of the sessions are in German. You know, I'll be doing mine in slow English. If you're anywhere nearby, I'd love to see you there. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another day.